everyone once again. A pleasant welcome to the official program marking the 72nd anniversary of the United Nations Day here at the Centennial Memorial Pavilion, Ashman Street, Monrovia, at about now. Like I said, we have our students here, our distinguished students. You know, this year's celebration is focusing on the Sustainable Development Goals. We have 17 of them, and the students are wearing t-shirts with the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. We'd just like to ask them to stand at this time. Our students, let's give them a round of applause.
On behalf of the government of Liberia, the United Nations system, and the Liberian United Nations Association, I take this distinguished honor and pleasure to welcome you all to this formal Indo program marking the 72nd anniversary of the founding of the United Nations. The United Nations various agencies, funds, and programs have brought in food, shelter, clothing, and medicine to those who most dearly need them. Mothers and children in the poorest countries, the victims of war, famine, and natural disasters. In Liberia, the invaluable role of the United Nations in the restoration of peace and democracy, coupled with efforts regarding national reconstruction, economic recovery, the rule of law, among others, cannot be overemphasized. It is against these and other backdrops that we have converged on this hallowed ground this morning to celebrate this historic day with events befitting the United Nations. Distinguished platform guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure once again to introduce this to together and say welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. So move ahead, and at this time, we will have remarks by Amel SRSG Farid Sarif. And following that, we will play, we'll all sit and listen to the Secretary General's UN Day message.
Excellency Madam Merchant Kamara, Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Liberia. Excellency Senator Tommy Bissi, distinguished senior representatives of the government, and dear colleagues from the diplomatic community, dear students, guests, and all participants. I'd like to begin by thanking you for your participation in today's celebration of the United Nations Day. This has become a tradition in Liberia to acknowledge the importance and contribution of the United Nations towards the betterment of life in Liberia through enthusiastic participation in the anniversaries of the United Nations. I was pleasantly surprised this morning to read that Madame President has proclaimed the 24th of October as a working holiday throughout Liberia. This is a very pleasant surprise because the farthest you could go in recognizing an important day is to make sure that every citizen in the country becomes a participant in it and celebrates it. So I'd like to use this posture in order to express deep gratitude and thanks to the Madam President for having initiated this annual holiday for the people of Liberia in recognition of the United Nations' role in this country. Much has been said about what the UN has done since its creation. It has saved lives, and there are thousands around the world. It has provided inoculation and saved the lives of children and fought against communicable diseases that would cost many thousands of lives everywhere in the world. It has provided protection to millions of refugees who have been forced out of their countries and sought shelter in the neighboring countries. it has provided relief to millions of people who are affected by natural calamities. It has been there in order to prevent wars, it has been there to contain and stop wars. Over the past 72 years, the UN has been good. More than 50 peacekeeping operations around the world. Most of those countries are now living in peace. And the contribution the UN peacekeepers have made towards bringing peace in those countries can be felt by every single individual who lived then and the succeeding generations that followed them. In Liberia, in addition to the multitude of contributions made by the government of the United Nations funds, agencies, and programs, the peacekeeping operation here succeeded in helping the people of Liberia to emerge from the ashes of the war and to start building their lives in peace and in stability, marching towards creating a society that matches the aspiration of every individual in the country for a better life, a more developed economy, education for all, and health coverage for all. We are proud of having been part of this struggle of the Liberian people to bring back stability and peace to the country and to create an enabling environment for all Liberians to come together and march towards achieving all their objectives in the future. We have just put behind ourselves a very important benchmark. The elections held here on the 10th of October for the presidency and for the House of Representatives will go a long way in order to strengthen the foundations of democracy and good governance in this country. We're still ahead of us having the second round of presidential elections, and we truly hope that this second round will be as peaceful and as calm and as participatory as we witnessed it during the first round of presidential elections. The Liberian people can pride themselves for having learned appropriate lessons from their recent bitter past, and they have united in order to work towards conducting themselves in a very civilized and peaceful way, going through this important process. We're hoping that Liberia once again would start establishing examples for other nations around the world, including in the region and in the whole of Africa, to become again the lone star it used to be, giving beacon of hope and guidance to the others in their joint effort to work towards the accomplishment of the Sustainable Development Agenda, which is now the United Nations roadmap for the entire human community, human race. I wish the people of Liberia, I wish the leadership of Liberia every success in their struggle for the achievement of their aspirations in the future. Thank you very much.
And marched around Monrovia, Thank you very much. And of course, my UN family, the SRG, heads of UN agency, dear colleagues from the United Nations, members of the press, a very good morning to you and happy 72nd. I was asked to say a few words, and even if the Secretary General of the United Nations has spoken, and even if the Special Representative of the Secretary General has spoken, but I will say a few words because it's an opportunity not to be missed. On the 26th of June 1945, 51 countries founded the United Nations, and that is when Liberia, as a founding member of the United Nations, signed the charter, and on the 2nd of November, the instrument of ratification was deposited. That is when Liberia ratified the charter. So all of us are gathered here to say happy birthday to the United Nations, but it is more than that. All of us are gathered here today, and some of us are privileged to be serving in Liberia, this founding member of the United Nations, and who happen to be serving in Liberia at these times. When the UN was born, it was born to pursue four key goals. First and foremost, to stop the war and never again to allow war to be. And that is why the first noble goal of the United Nations was the maintenance of international peace and security. The Secretary General of the Liberia United Nations Association, when he spoke to us, cited some parts of the charter, including this particular one, to save succeeding generations from the scourge of war, which in our lifetime, which twice in our lifetime, brought unprecedented sorrow to mankind. So the UN was born because war was just becoming unbearable and was too devastating to humankind. The second goal is to protect human rights. The third goal is to respect the rule of law. The fourth goal is to ensure social progress and improving the quality of life for all. In other words, these days we call it development. When we look at each one of these four, and we see the partnership between Liberia and the United Nations, we see a lot of work that has been done there. UNMIL is a good example, because UNMIL deployed 14 years ago and it stopped the war in Liberia. So all of you, dear students, are growing up in a Liberia that is war-free. Because for the last 14 years, there hasn't been war. And when the UNMIL deployed, Liberia had been going through difficult times. So it is one example of how the United Nations can work with countries and deliver. And in this case, on the maintenance of international peace and security, you could argue that the United Nations succeeded in Liberia. On protecting human rights, a lot has been done. In fact, in July this year, the National Independent Commission for Human Rights in Liberia was ranked and accredited at the Human Rights Council, and the ranking was the highest in terms of the vision, in terms of the commitment, and in terms of the work done, including by individual members of the Commission in pursuit of the protection of human rights. And that was done in partnership and with some support from the United Nations. So here, the credit goes to the Liberians, both in the commission and in the human rights groups and in civil society and in the communities. The international community, including the United Nations, may have supported, but the leadership and the ownership of this is indeed with the Liberian people. There is work that has been done, a lot of work. There's a lot of work that still has to be done in Liberia. When the UN was born, Ma'ellen was 6 years old. You know who I'm talking about, students? She was 6 years old. And it was tough to go to school in those days. She did. And she worked hard. She became not only a leader in the United Nations later on, she became the leader of this country for the last 12 years, where you today are able to go to school without having to worry, or your parents worrying whether you will come back at the end of the day, because the war stopped, and because you are able to get your education. But the job is not done when we are talking human rights. 62% of you, the students who should be in school, are not in school in Liberia today. That is homework for Liberia, but that is homework for all of us, friends of Liberia, working to improve this situation. If only 28% are able to go to school, then there is a serious problem. If rape continues to be rampant and the perpetrators get away with it, and women and girls continue to be victimized, there is work to be done. That is where, much as a lot has been done, there is work to be done. Let's not be complacent when we celebrate the birthday, the 72nd birthday of the United Nations. And there are many areas where a lot of work that has been done could be the foundation for more to be done as Liberia goes forward. Respect for the rule of law is another noble goal. And here is where you could argue that one of the areas where some tangible progress in Liberia since the war stopped has been that area. But there is still a lot of weaknesses, a lot of delay, and a lot of incapacity. When it comes to the performance of security agencies, you could also here argue that this is one of the areas that has witnessed tangible progress. I think the professionalism with which you see the police conducting its work and other security agencies, because of support, training, investment by the government of Liberia, but also friends of Liberia, including the United Nations, this has helped improve. And that is good. But there is way to go. And that's homework for all of us, led by Liberia. And of course, development. As the SRSD said, Liberia led the world in carving the global agenda which you are carrying now on your chests. Madame Sirleaf, the president of Liberia, was one of three high-level personalities that co-chaired this panel that oversaw the development of the millennium or the sustainable development goals. So Liberia is already showing the way. But Liberia now has the task of translating that global vision, which it took to the world, to translate that global vision to here, at community level, at village level, and on all fronts, all of them 17 fronts. Liberia has work to do, and Liberia has 13 years to do that. And with the support of the international community, that is possible. But the work must not wait anymore. Now, I started by talking about UNMIL as a good example of where the UN can be effective. And UNMIL in Liberia is indeed a success story. But UNMIL is legal. In fact, from many counties in Liberia, if you travel around the country, you see that UNMIL has left. And come the end of March next year, UNMIL will substantively stop working in Liberia. Upon completion, successful completion of the mandate given it by the Security Council. Many Liberians think the UN is leaving because UNMIN is leaving. I have good news, and please carry this back to the classrooms and to your friends and to your communities and to your families. In Liberia, we have a team that is comprised of all the UN agencies and other international organizations working in your country. That team has 21 members, 21 institutions. UNMIN is one of them. The 20 are not leaving. In fact, none of them is leaving with UNMIN. And that is the good news that I want to bring here. As Liberia led the way over the last several years, and the UN and other partners who are supporting, Liberia will continue to own and lead the way, and these 20 international organizations that also include the World Bank, the International Monetary Fund, the International Finance Corporation, and the African Development Bank. I know you know UNICEF, and WFP, and WHO, and UNHCR, and many, many others. They are not leaving because there is work to do. And as long as Liberia invites these UN entities to stay, they will continue, and they will continue to provide the needed support and providing the needed delivery of programs that will, this time, not do peacekeeping, but help Liberia do peace building. And as Liberia has proved to be a success story in peacekeeping terms, let's all work together in the coming phase to make sure also that Liberia is a success story in peace building and peace consolidation terms. So, congratulations to Liberia for having had the foresight and the vision 72 years ago to be part of a community of nations that gave birth to the United Nations, which we are celebrating today. But also congratulations to Liberia for having, over the last 12 years, as this government has been in office, laying the foundation for a very bright and prosperous future, and also bringing back something that was lost during the years of the war, when Liberians sorted their differences through the logic of force. Liberians today are sorting their differences through the force of logic. Let's keep it that way. Thank you very much.
To making known to the people of the world the aims and objectives of the UN. United Nations, and of 1971 for member states to observe it as a public holiday. What better way to keep alive the relevance of the United Nations than teaching and making it part of the upbringing of our children of the world? In Liberia, the United Nations carry very special meaning to many different people. To historians, the United Nations organization was that creation by 51 countries of the world to signal the end of World War II. It is one of which Liberia is a founding member. It provided the platform for Liberia, the first independent republic in Africa, to play a very active part in international affairs. In particular, Liberia used the United Nations to lead the struggle for African independence from colonial rule, for struggles against the racist apartheid regime and system of white supremacy, for a dedicated and forceful advocacy for the liberation of Southwest Africa, now Namibia, from South African colonial domination, and for the promotion of Pan-Africanism. To those of us who saw fire, blood, sweat, and tears as a result of the 14 years of war that erupted on the eve of Christmas 1989, that led to the death of over 250,000 people, the displacement of hundreds of thousands of others, and the incalculable destruction of economic and other infrastructure and services, the United Nations played an extraordinary role in helping our country end the armed violence, disarm and demobilize combatants, and help rebuild hope. We saw the UN in the form of UNOMIC and UNMIC, and the numerous UN agencies. As we remember, the UN from 1993, we do acknowledge the Economic Community of West African States, whose young men and women operating under ECOWAS pay the highest price for Liberia to live. To others, the UN and its agencies are sources of economic well-being, employment, and social cohesion. To yet others, the UN stood with us when Ebola was threatening to wipe Liberia from the face of the earth. For some of those too young like you all to have seen fire, the UN is a simple source of admiration and at once envy. To yet others, especially the politicians now struggling for political power, the UN is a source of additional confidence in the electoral process. All in all, the United Nations in Liberia deserve very special gratitude, appreciation, and honor for its role in the restoration of peace and stability in our country. Please give yourself a hand. In extending our gratitude to the UN and its agencies, we are mindful that this creation is made of 193 member states, each of whom must be noted for its contribution to the achievements that our country has made thus far. There are many among you today whose contribution we need not mention. You've been our friends, and we've been very, very grateful for all your contribution to the successes that we've attained so thus far. In the last 30 or more years, the most profound of Liberia's achievements can be measured in terms of peace and stability. It has been so peaceful. It really has been so peaceful and so stable that some people have forgotten that for 14 years our country was smelling everywhere of corpses, mostly of hundreds of thousands of innocent men, women, and children. That there was destruction everywhere, battered schools, universities, training institutions, hospitals, clinics, public buildings, homes, streets and highways, buildings, bridges, and above all, human minds. It is because of what we have achieved that we seem to even forget that today is United Nations Day. That shows some progress use at will without any consequence. There was no justice and there was no choice. Yes, we have forgotten that since Liberia signed the Comprehensive Peace Agreement in Accra on August 18, 2003, we have kept to our pledge to make war no more. Yes, we have forgotten that it is now 14 years of peace, successfully balancing off 14 years of war. Yes, we must remember that 12 of those 14 years of peace are the years during which Mrs. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf provided extraordinary and sacrificial leadership to our country. Our hand, please.
Adopted a resolution declaring October 24th
continues to support all programs of the World Body as an expression of his constant appreciation, particularly with emphasis on the operation of the United Nations mission in Liberia. And whereas the United Nations organization and its member states have played and continue to play a critical role in the rebuilding of Liberia following its civil crisis, for which we remain most grateful. And whereas Liberia will celebrate the 72nd anniversary of the United Nations Day under the theme Potential in Diversities. Now, therefore, I, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia, by virtue of the authority in me vested, do hereby declare and proclaim Tuesday, October 24, 2017, as United Nations Day to be observed throughout the Republic as a working holiday in recognition of the invaluable contributions of the United Nations. Furthermore, I do call upon all government ministries and agencies, international organizations, United Nations agencies near this capital, schools, and other institutions of learning, and citizens in general, to cooperate with the Ministry of Education in organizing appropriate programs befitting the occasion. Giving honor my hand and seal of the Republic of Liberia in the city of Monrovia, County of Mosarado, this 24th day of October, in the year of our Lord 2017, and of the independence of the Republic, the 100th.